Hello students. Today we will discuss the concept of magnetism and matter. Before going to the concept of magnetism and matter, I would like to give you certain key points regarding the magnetism. That is, history of magnetism. Once Magnus was herding his sheep in an area of northern Greece called Magnesia, suddenly both the nails of his shoes and the metal tip of his staff became firmly stuck to the large black rock on which he was standing. He was very curious to know the fact behind it. Therefore, to find the source of attraction, he dug up the earth and he finds lodestone. This is how the lodestone looks like. A lodestone which contains magnetite, a natural magnetic material Fe3O4. Students, keep in mind again, a lodestone which contains magnetite, which is nothing but a natural magnetic material Fe3O4. Okay? Fine. So, the directional property of magnet was also known since ancient times. That is, a freely suspended magnet and the magnet which placed on a piece of cork allowed to float in still water, always pointed in the north-south direction. This is how we can recognize the directional property of the magnet, a freely suspended magnet, and the magnet which placed on a piece of cork and float in still water always points in north to the south direction. Okay? So, they have also used these magnets in many applications. One of the application we'll see now. You can look at the image. The image is a chariot. With that, a magnetic idol is suspended. The craftsman built a chariot on which they placed a magnetic figure which swirled around so that the finger of the statuette on it always pointed south. With this chariot, Hongti troops were able to attack the enemies from the rear in thick fog and to defeat them. This was one of the applications in the earlier days using the magnets. And the later science suggests that moving charges or electric currents produce magnetic field. Moving charges or electric currents produce magnetic fields. This discovery was credited to the scientist Orested, Ampere, Biot and Savart. Dear students, now we'll discuss the common ideas regarding the magnetism. That is, the first one is, the earth behaves as a magnet with the magnetic field pointing approximately from geographic south to the geographic north. What does that mean? On the whole, we can treat the earth as a magnet, where the magnetic field pointing approximately from geographic south to the geographic north. Next, when a bar magnet is freely suspended, it points in the north-south direction. This property you know. When a bar magnet is freely suspended, it always points in what? North and south direction. Okay? The tip which points the geographic north is called the North Pole, and the tip which points the geographic south is called the South Pole. You can observe the tip which points the geographic north is the North Pole, and the tip which points the geographic south is South Pole. Okay? The next point is, like in electrostatics, here also you can get the properties like poles repels each other. What does that mean? If you bought two bar magnets of same poles, if you bought two bar magnets of same poles each other, those two bar magnets tend to repel from one another. Why is it so? Because between those two same poles, repulsive force exists. In the same way, unlike poles attract each other. That means, if you bought two bar magnets of opposite poles, those two bar magnets always attract each other. And that is because of the attractive force exists between the opposite poles. So that on the whole, I can conclude like pole repels each other and like pole attracts each other. And the next point is magnetic monopoles do not exist. What does that mean? Magnetic monopoles do not exist, which is nothing but if you cut a bar magnet into n equal pieces, if you cut a bar magnet into n equal pieces, each one will be having both south and the north poles. That means if you consider a bar magnet and make it into n slices, n number of slices, each slices what you have obtained will be always facilitated with the two poles. That is north pole, south pole, north pole, south pole, north pole, south pole. Therefore, we can say that magnetic monopoles do not exist. Okay. And the next point is, it is possible to make magnets out of iron and its alloys. Yes, we can manufacture magnets with the help of iron and its alloys. For example, the manufacture of Alnico magnets uses iron and its alloys. Alnico is nothing but what? Aluminium, nickel and cobalt. Okay, the further discussions will be in the next module. Till then, keep learning. Thank you.